Welcome everyone to this live stream. I guess maybe no real life. Precious SGI Octane wanted to shortly test network booting. Actually, I prepared this as per usual already last night, making T2 network booting great again. Last time I probably did this maybe nearly a decade ago. Surprisingly, it worked mostly just some tiny fget of certainly not having curl there for all the dependencies in the initRD. Worked in QEMU for the most part, already tweaked some stuff last night, including properly cross-compiling fget because, you know, strange make-based stuff. Flugzeug LKW came before the shiny old. The problem is, as usual, quickly, so I'm also accidentally added there more copyright than I wanted. Last night fixed fget to actually cross-compile. The only problem is, also simplified and cleaned up some PowerPC grub ISO while at it. So Linux for MIPS, that could probably maybe even work. So the problem as per usual, also wrong camera. I want my hotkeys back, bloody Wayland. The problem as per usual with this kind of fun stuff is actually the ARX bootloader and firmware stuff as per all usual, like, yeah, quickly something and then some hours later. Let's create the ISO. Let's also need to show you something else, like maybe this, while entering some secure password. We are back. All right, do we even show that? All right, I wanted to unmount this. Is this the right camera? Nearly. I also want my Wayland OBS scene stuff back. So U-mount MMT. So I also, target is busy actually. I'm in there. Remount that off on some server, obviously. So the problem is, what do we even see? The problem is bootloader stuff. Probably takes a while. I probably also need to better document that. All right, you probably need to be a little bit careful. This is a problem of this stuff not exposing it too much internal stuff. So the problem is so the arc load. Let's actually probably. I can show you that a little bit. The problem is always in the devil is always in the detail. So boot, so the arc load on the CD that we generate, so this probably, yeah, so this loads it from, I think, the volume header. So actually we are exotic systems and their boot stuff. So but we could we make this, if we make this the TFTP prefix, you know what, this could actually, so this SASH stuff here is arcload, just renamed. I decided this when I did this a month ago to rename this similar to IRIX. Then the install documentations, install instructions will be slightly different than IRIX, but you know what, this could actually work. I mean, conveniently we have this all, this is arcload and arccf. This could actually work from a read-only mounted ISO here, conveniently. Let's try that. What could possibly go wrong? Famous last words. Probably also need a third display sometime soon. So we do this with DNS mask here, because why not? And did I not wanted to delete that? So TFTP, okay, maybe I create here. We've soon turn on the SGI and then see what happens. Because I network booted the Octane, but that was in 2006, along a lot of water. So this would be in prefix MNT boot, but I will document this later. And to boot is actually we want to boot sesh 64. So TFTP MNT boot, MNT boot and sash 64. And yeah, maybe I actually need a dedicated internal network just for YouTube too. Not to expose too much stuff. So let's switch on here. So I'm only live on this channel here. A little bit to be careful with this brittle plastic stuff. So the next thing is, of course, documentation, the more documentation, the most documentation. Another problem is, of course, documentation, which is also why I set this on the other live stream yesterday with the PS3. Theoretically, we could also, maybe this looks tiny, little bit better like that, maybe. Oh shit, don't boot. Boot setup is too good. Boots Linux straight away. Slightly wonder. This should actually boot Linux. Maybe this was. Was it? No? Maybe we were lucky, not sure what happened there. Maybe I hit escape fast enough. Alright, you probably maybe want to see that, right? The precious Arx firmware stuff. But I, of course, will document this. This is also the point of this video. Just take some time. I probably also next really need to reverse engineer this Epiphone thing for better screen capture. So let's make a photo of my boot configuration, because that is big. I could actually use a serial terminal, but that would be too professional. Certainly 2020, everyone makes a photo of their boot configuration. Because so what we need is so system partition, probably we want setenv system part partition boot p. Maybe it needs a colon there, setenv system partition. And we want to always load file name. Why do we have here? Alright, so these are two. So this is always load. There should be a sesh 64, and maybe the OS setenv OS load file name, and yeah, not should be probably install. I think I named this install. So let's see what happens. Load file name, getting something from server. So far, so good. Wait a second. Do we have OS load? Maybe we also need, so it tries to load the stuff from disk 011 XFS. That is, of course, yeah, not amused. I said this previously. Maybe I want my own microkernel hardware abstraction layer stuff be bootloader, because it's old fashioned bootloaders. Yeah. So also setenv OS load partition. That probably should also be boot p. It's been some days since I tried that though. And yeah, you get some MAC address, but yeah, whatever. I guess it probably could work. Let's see what happens this time. And yeah, vintage stuff is difficult. And whatnot, do we get more this time? Loading configuration for install, obtaining ArcCF from server, file not found, MNT boot install, file not found, arc open failed, boot p install. All right, is this not named install? Wait a second, why do we have initrd? What? Why? I thought I had here install. No. Why do we not have? Wait, I thought previously we had install there. Right, previously we had install there. Something in the ISO must not be perfect. How was it? What did I run recently? I've run rerun create ISO? Maybe. Let's mount MIPS 64 CD1 ISO 2 MNT and see if we have a. No, there's not an install. Darn. I somehow YOLO'd that the last time. Why is it not there? Architecture MIPS 6, some boot. Some boot script. What did I do with the install? Where was that coming from in my fancy scripting? I think I had some special glue because some of the Octane kernels still had some initrd hiccups. I had here some custom rebuilding stuff. Apparently that I'm shown. Yeah, so this is a little bit YOLO'd. Unfortunately, we need to wait some minutes. What we could do while waiting some minutes for that. You mount. Oh, this is TempFS. But not a big problem for this epic thread ripping AMD Ryzen. Just some 6 minutes or so. What we could do while it, there's also a new QEMU version out there, whatever that was of QEMU.org. That would be 520. Maybe our data would update this, but we can also update this already now. Yes, so there are always, even if you already for weeks and months and years and 100 YouTube videos perfect your stuff, at the end of the day there's always one more thing, especially the initrd. I even debugged multiple videos live here on this channel. I'm not sure, there's some really strange memory corruption going on. I'm not even entirely sure if this is Arc load or the init, the Linux kernel. Some really, really, really strange stuff going on there. But yeah, IT is hard and stuff, and anyway, testing and more testing. So that builds, and let's, I think this was create ISO directly, right? Caps lock is crazy, caps lock stuff. This is also a testament of why this stuff is always so time consuming. So then let's copy that over. I probably also need to update here some password dialog thing. Megabytes per second. And then you mount MNT and mount again. Now we have an install there. So let's try that again. Also sometime soon next I need to. It's of course now you're running the future Wayland here. Previous videos and don't have hotkeys anymore. So let's try that again. I guess it all it takes is run boot again. That certainly should load the same files there. Let's hope that this time we have an install. The install is just in kernel initrd in one image for working around this memory corruption thing of either arc load or loading kernel boot install. Let's see what happens. Honestly didn't try this. The problem is of course not only this YouTube videos. I'm certainly very much, hey, we're booting something, yay, network boot of an Octane first time in. Actually I think I network booted that previously this year, but not the install thing. So this hopefully could theoretically lead to a usable install. Let's see. This looks so far so good. And the reason is last night already, because if we would analyze and debug and rebuild this, pro tip always test with virtualization. I didn't virtualize MIP64, although I probably could with QEMU, but needing another kernel of because this bloody MIPS and ARM specific kernel stuff. So let's test this, because I tested here this network configuration thing. Let's hope that works. 3 was R2 configure network interfaces. S0, I could, wait a second, why did, so auto, so in QEMU that worked, stuff that worked, and so last night it didn't work, previous video, not previous video, changelog, I don't even make a video of all the random stuff, although I wonder if I like Louis Rossmann stream each random garbage. I have the feeling though, the more random garbage I stream here, the less happy the people are, but yeah, last night fixed this already. And one thing I probably do is loading second stage. So I tested this also in QEMU. All right, one thing we need to do is actually, they just moved this over, but doesn't matter too much. So for network installation, you need to run some HTTP server, which was that. So let's see, do we have Gartling here? No, we don't see the user. So let's quickly on the server build Gartling. Gartling is from Felix from Leitner. Also, is it? It's from him. But what I will probably do, I said this before, some decade ago had uttermost respect to Felix von Leitner, some famous blogger and security researcher here in Germany. But the more I see from his C code, the less impressed I became. In our microkernel and everything from scratch series, I will probably also implement some tiny HTTP server. Like basically, I'm still brainstorming of the problem is re-implementing everything from scratch is certainly a lifetime undertaking. Scripts emerge, missing only Gartling. Of course, I could use everything else, but Gartling is at least somewhat small. In this educational YouTube series stuff and microkernel stuff, I'm still debating whether I should for clean code and education write everything from scratch, or if I should, like Steve Jobs, famous artist, steal and copy quote stuff, copy more stuff from people. The problem is, of course, also which language to use, and whether some C++ or Rust or all the things. What do you mean with effing finally booted? No, I'm not sure what. Anyway, also life was cute SGI. Also, I'm somewhat debating, it's of course somewhat nice, this per architecture. Probably most of you have never, probably I should actually properly zoom into that of SGI logo stuff. However, I'm debating, I said this before, more T2 logo, maybe I should actually custom patch this. Not sure if it works it with our own T2 kind of penguin stuff. And whether it's inverse to keep some per architecture logo overlay of Sun versus SGI. Maybe it's cool, maybe it isn't. Leave in the comments below, or maybe it's pointless waste of time. Also, maybe it's branding and advertising and fun little stuff. Maybe it isn't. Anyway, so here's a server, not the super fastest AMD Epic thread ripping stuff. Also, best, so also key bindings. I didn't build OpenSSL, shit. Some OpenSSL, NodeSSL strings, can we? I only need Gartling quickly, darn it. Can we disable? Make file of SSL. TLS Gartling of... where do we have? TLS Gartling, let's quickly comment that out, and libofed.io, what? Why would that fail? Maybe, nah. So much too quickly build Gartling, which do I even, so much of it. Only life on this channel, always something failing, but it's not the super newest T2 installation. What do we have here? Include libofed. Here's libofed, libofed. Maybe that is an issue. Maybe it shouldn't be like that. Let's move for a test. User include libofed. Everything to user include. They probably changed something in the make file. Libofed. Hello? But yeah, testing, more testing threads. Darn it, what's wrong with... Why is here no threads? Where does it want that from? Darn it, quickly build that thing, they said. Let's better... Oops, don't tell me that crashed. Maybe it crashed, what? Shit. Crashed or wherever that disappeared to. So yeah, not a live stream without something possibly going wrong and something to debug, because now let's see what's going up with that fun stuff there. User source, so that would be, they probably changed to some makefile stuff of include there, so apparently they that's in there, so let's mine RF fed. Maybe they even have some bug in the make file, you never know. Or maybe actually let's low fit off. Do they have here? No, they don't have thread. Not sure where. Did they remove that? That's also, yeah, not a build error without live stream without build error lib. Fat threads or something dot h. Or is this only diet libc threads maybe? Oh, this is if dev, oh wait a second, something, otherwise piece threads. Oh, we have again use Wayland, it's the future, we have already this strange. No idea where is it happens. We don't even this video, huh? Some strange video capturing stuff. Lip low, lip low fat. Sick. So yeah, that's what's with Gartling. Also yeah, at least so much testing, testing, more testing. You just want to install your Linux on your Octane and fix here some generic include directory stuff, but yeah. What is, so this is include IOH 148, so this is okay, we don't have diet libc installed, which I also don't really want today. Does it have here diet? Doesn't build with diet libc, or does it? I don't want diet libc right now. If the something something a GNU make file, make diet to build without diet. Okay, make diet equals that evil. Maybe we need to do that then in the make file. Undefined g get entropy. Nah. If maybe this glibc is not new enough, obviously maybe I need to update this virtual machine sometime soon. Nothing you can't quirk for a test. Only quickly wanted a tiny HTTP server. Anyway, OpenSSL, yeah, whatever. So do we have Gartling? Oh, we have some Gartling. Does it work? Apparently it does work. Copy Gartling to user bin or something. Of course, normally it should install, but I'm right now not interested in the rest of all this. Oh, wait a second, why is... Oops. Now this actually looks about right, but diet libc, actually, why? Oh, this is make install, wait a second. No make run, since it builds a lot of test stuff. Oh, okay, that is the reason. So, anyway, actually this is funny that we have here open TLS Gartling. Okay, fine. Whatever. So then we go to our network mounted MNT boot. Not MNT boot, actually here. And Gartling just... and we need directory listing. I think this was dash D for directory listing. So this is just a tiny HTTP server. If you run the other stuff, usually then you obviously can use that. Let's go back to our Octane here. And let's see what happens when we second stage from, oh no, shit, can we control? Let's use something that doesn't exist. Nah, something. Where is load? Did I not? Ah, this is one. Maybe actually this is a little bit stupid. It starts with zero, no, but maybe. The problem is also, yeah, even confused. Or maybe it was a joke. Don't even remember. Maybe it was a joke starting from zero because computer science. But anyway, that's maybe not the super most convenient. Anyway, HTTP colon double slash 192.6.8.2.1. Root here and address family not supported. What the heck? Socket failed. What 192.168? What address family not supported? What is that? A MIP64 thing? The problem is we don't have ifconfig here in this early stage, and the other is some tiny IP config. Invalid option, yeah, thank you very much. But why would that not work? HTTP. Was is this somehow miscompiled? Socket failed. Address family not supported. What the heck? It could be. I mean, this is also the challenge with cross-compiled stuff. Could actually have used the wrong header. Maybe we compiled that here against wrong system headers, potentially. Let's see what it maybe run in the log of fget. This comes from using other. Do we see? All right, this is using some. I fixed this last night. Maybe this has some hard-coded include header stuff. Yeah, so much to using, not really as the most amazing things for that. Do they have here some manual include stuff? I also wonder, so we have here, what does it even build? Let's see. It builds not everything. What does it even? Yeah, amazing build system stuff. The result of people using. Anyway, I only wanted, was mostly interested in actually F. It has a man page. Yeah, also using tiny stuff for network install stuff, and of course the drawback is using obscure stuff here. Yeah, Felix von Leitner, so much too obscure stuff. Oh, wait a second, I didn't want, did I say fget? Wait a second, it's not even the right thing I wanted. Maybe we should check if the other thing, because we use here some, what even is that? This was some tiny network stuff. Um, What even was this? If not if config or net. Actually, we could. Do we have more or? Oh, you don't even see this. I forgot to. What was this of netconfig of? Maybe I should actually. Target generic. Shared install init. Network of IP config, obviously. This is actually what I wanted to check. If this has some option to check the IP configuration. IP config, some old shit from. Yeah, just for. Small also doesn't have help, right? So what does it have? It has P for port number. What else does it have? If config main. Does it have some check auto config binding source port? No. Add all devices. Print device. I mean, it printed the right stuff, right? Print device. Config is called from complete device. No, only complete device. I mean, it printed that correctly, I think. Although now we scrolled all the stuff away. I wonder, do we have this in? Welcome everyone from work. I wonder if we have this in this class network S0. Oh, there's some address. Oh, we don't have grep here. Yeah. So hardware address, does it have? I mean, it printed the right thing. I wonder. I mean, we could probably. So what? Probably mostly is fget miscompiled, as this is saying address family not supported. And it prints the right stuff. The only question is, did it also configure that? To find out. Yeah, so the problem is always on a real system, this would of course always be not an issue. The issue is this super tiny install RAM disk. That is the issue. Because we don't have the S-trace, we don't have a debugger. I mean, we could actually, but obviously it says address family not supported, so I don't even need to check. No, of course there's nothing. So this is a little bit, well, it booted smoother than I expected, only I mean, if config works in the installed system, I mean, very theoretically, we could mount, I mean, it's a full system. I could theoretically mount dev disks. And change root in there. Why is this block device without part? Or maybe I did. No partition table, type SGI, what? Ah, oh, maybe this bloody. Oh, this bloody disk type doesn't understand SGI partitions apparently. Let's mount. What is that there? XFS dev sdb2 to root or mmt. Bad version? What? Why is there always something not working? SDA, we could also try SDA. With SDA, something, I did this for block ID SDA. SDA 1, so they are they all? SDA 1 is swap and SDA 2 is XFS maybe? This mounted cleanly. So the point of that would be change root in here with bin bash. Because here we have ifconfig. So here that is correctly configured. Here, and this wasn't properly cross-compiled previously, that's x86 64, which I fixed last night. The only problem now, so curl probably would do HTTP. Let's see if that would work with curl in the previously installed system, HTTP 1 and 2. Always need to be a little bit creative. So yeah, that works. So something is wrong with this bloody fget still. So most likely that is not using the right headers, I guess. Socket failed, address family not supported. Actually, you know what? We could copy this and strace this from. You see, you always need to be a little bit creative. From how the heck do we debug this to here? Let's just. Ah, shit. Mount bin bash. Also, yeah, bib stuff memory faulting because, yeah, it's 2020 and you do some stuff wrong. Where did I? Did I not Oh, here's a get. What does it say? Or maybe this is a. So this is N32. What did I even build? So this apparently, obviously, doesn't have the glibc there. But you know what? We can MNT. Let's go totally crazy. Bind mount T T none bind root to MNT. T source MNT or option bind, because then we have that in here to debug like lib 64 LD F get. Yeah, and do we have a or we can we S trace follow children change root here? Bin fget what do we get here? Address family not supported, so that is here N64. It actually prints this here, so socket. So what does it do? Access open at read map mmap close protect something open at socket. So it does socket OXA OX2. So here there's something going wrong. E address family no support, address family not supported. Yeah, so much to that. It's compiling there something. But you know, so there's always something shiny little stuff. The only reason I changed that, so previously I think I built MNT, previously I think I built N32. Yeah, N32. And so the difference is that is N64, 64-bit pointers. I only changed this actually for the previous videos, Firefox stuff on MIPS, which, fun fact, also doesn't work yet. Yeah, we could... I mean, everything else works except this fget, so... I mean, most likely, do we have power off here? Probably not. Yeah, we probably could just we could also control alt delete, I guess. So yeah, there's always something recurring theme here. But yeah, this is how you would network boot this. In general, it works. I wanted to improve one more thing, which is automatically changing the default to the gateway server, so that maybe often you wouldn't have something to type. Tar. So yeah, next I would need to debug what's wrong. I didn't build verbose. Epic thread ripping Horizon just builds this a little bit fast. So the challenge I had already last night, maybe I pressed this fast enough. This was maybe tempfs config mips. So yeah, time consuming stuff. Unfortunately, stuff doesn't always work, especially with exotic stuff. But yeah, soon we will write the stuff from scratch. because this vintage C code doesn't cut it anymore in 2020. I only wonder, does it have here some dish I grep? Dish I in all of that include, because something is going wrong here and I wonder what it is. That is a little bit annoying to debug. I mean, we probably, well, I could SCP this or rsync or to see in the installed system whether curl works. If this is something generically we have here some file is wrapper readlock though. Let's see, include, where does it, if we are lucky this should have all the includes. No, this R user include thing though, so I really wonder where that is going wrong. Well, I could, the question is, should we just rebuild for N32? With, well, because it could be a generic N64 hiccup. The question is simply rebuild everything with N32 for a little bit higher performance anyway, which maybe actually make sense. I mean, theoretically, this bug should of course be fixed, but in general, I'm getting a little bit tired of fixing other people's bugs, so. What, why is this even word size times? Are those correct here? Word size, Nipsen. Word size 32, some of they look strange. Oh no, they are also word size. What the heck? Is this also word size, you long? What? Maybe we compact stuff. Maybe I, for a test, simply rebuild this with N32 because there's always so much time I want to spend fixing other people's stuff. The point of this video was mostly, certainly it looks somewhat random, but I also want to get everything in amazing order because certainly I can't advertise. I missed shit, there was MIPS. I just made their typo. Because certainly I can't advertise this as most amazing news distributions and stuff isn't working. And also, I said this previously, getting a little bit bored, burning optical rotating media stuff. So, smart and tempfs. Let's rebuild this and hope this works better. It's higher performance anyway. And the other, oh wait a second, I might have here. So yeah, it's mostly testing and certainly fget, certainly network install didn't work at all because fget wasn't cross-compiled previously. A decade ago this wasn't visible because we didn't cross-compile everything and waited a week to build stuff on natively on this old stuff. But yeah, fixing the last stuff of cross-compiling everything, which certainly obviously is super amazing, because then we can, as you see, build everything on an EPYC third-ripping AMD Ryzen. So let's maybe tonight see that we have this working. I need to go for actually eating something. Wow, is it gray outside? No, my girl will not like this because... So yeah, going home, eating something, some baby afternoon shift. My wife to see some sunshine in this gray, dizzy Berlin. We fixed some lip-o-fat thing of not amazing C libraries, and hopefully we have a more amazing ISO. I guess the previous ISO probably has a chance to work, hopefully. I just will leave the ISO there, because not everyone necessarily installed this, because I spent the electrons building that, and maybe some people want 64-bit stuff. I will just add the second ISO next to this for N32 and hopefully network booting stuff. And I slightly wonder, can we... what I mean is... did we also, by the way, build QEMU? Maybe not. So what I mean is defaulting HTTP server there to the gateway or DHCP server. Might be a little bit tricky to script in there with this bloody tools. I wonder if IPv4, if we have whether you get the maybe also port no find that are per process IPv stuff. I wonder if we can get this from proc or somewhere for shell scripting. Per process net stuff. Anyway, that's probably it for this video. I will let this build. Did I also build this? No. This is, of course, one thing that is probably theoretically maybe. Also, I'll patch the zoom to fit in. No, that doesn't apply anymore. Did I build with... So much to custom patching this stuff. Find, reject. What did they change there? Tiny little patch that annoyed me for a while. Zoom to fit true. Let's see. Don't tell me they... Zoom to fit. No, they didn't change the default, just more fix file. I really wonder who wouldn't want this as a default. Whatever. Not much send off stuff here. Anyway, so this is always, yeah, this is a little bit the thing of streaming something random. There's always something going wrong, obviously, with all the complexity of modern operating system. I hope you learned something, among other things, what exotics, more stuff exists. But yeah, a decade later, in 2005, this small suckless stuff could still impress me, but I said it already, that color faded quite a bit. Ah, shit. Mason version. I wonder, can we simply patch this? Yeah, the problem is I can't update to. Oh, this is modern shit. The problem is, yeah, this is also why I started this YouTube channel and I'm getting somewhat depressed here. The problem with this new Meson stuff is, I wonder which other project that also was. I think I tried to patch this, but I think the new Meson has some new options that are incompatible with the syntax or whatever. So just patching this, I tried this with another package, probably will not work. And the problem is with this new Meson version is, isn't that a new Brave World? Each update and package and stuff requires a new version, the latest version, because you can't let people run a 6 months old version. The new version doesn't build cross-compile Mesa, I think. So probably eventually I need to spend also an afternoon debugging the bloody LLVM cross-compile glue of Mesa there, Mesa 3D library stuff. It's like, yeah, this is another day anyway. Yeah, super annoying, a lot of stuff, unfortunately. Hope you learned something and enjoyed this. Leave in the comments below.